Okay. So that's great. So we have gone through all of these questions for everybody. And what would you say that you learned about everyone in this room and each other?
There's only one programmer.
There's only one programmer?
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
There's two programmers.
Two programmers?
There's got to be a god to do programming.
Okay. On the end over there, that computer looks like it's not on. Just
Broken.
there should be like some words on the screen.
It's broken.
Okay, I hear you.
There is no C, so it's kind of sad.
What do the words say?
It says to press F1 to continue or F2 to run a setup completely.
Why don't you try clicking F1? See what happens. I mean, let's get crazy.
Hey, everybody,
okay.
I learned something.
I do what I can, you know. No, I'm just. What's up?
I somehow have watched like every single anime that people have said was their favorite. I don't know if that's a good thing
I
or
don't
a
doubt
bad
that.
thing.
With you, I don't doubt that. No, I'm just kidding. Okay. Yes, anime. The anime question. I put the anime question on there because after years and years of doing this, whenever I say fun, a lot of people automatically say anime. So I'm just like, well, what anime? Just tell us what anime you're watching. What was I going to tell you? Yeah, so we already went over these questions. That's great. Okay, bunch of other things I want to go over. We all have a lot of stuff in common, right? That's kind of what I wanted to get at here. We're all similar, and we have stuff in common, and what brings us all together, and we play video games and all that good stuff. Okay. Got my little list here of stuff I want to go over. Yep, we have done that. Sick policy. Okay, I have a sick policy, and my sick policy is I do take attendance in here. I have this rare ability where, actually, I'm not going to talk about that, but I remember everything. Okay, I don't know why, but I just do. But my sick policy is if you are sick, stay home. And I'm cool with that, all right? If we need you for the game or whatever it is, we'll reach out to you. But I'd rather you stay home and get better and focus on getting better than come in here and get people sick. Does that make sense? Because then we get more people sick and then they got to stay home and then, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
We had like, I don't even know if you guys, this was like the sickest December I've ever seen in my entire life. Everybody got sick. Who in here got the flu? I did.
Yeah, but that was like right after the semester ended, so.
Yeah, like I never get the flu, and it was like crazy. So, yeah, there's been a lot of. So anyway, if you're sick, just stay home. It's all good. Like, it's all good. What else? Oh yeah, so we have a lot of stuff that we do. So somebody said it was talking about game design class. I can't remember who was one of the last people that went up. So, yes, this is a game design class, but it's part of a game degree that we have here. We have an entire degree, and I'm going to talk about the degree here in a second, but there are two parts to our degree, and some of you guys talked about it. There is an art, animation, and design creative side, and then there's the programming side. As a programmer, you're just going to learn all programming, because that's all you're going to be doing if you're a programmer. On the creative side, there's a bunch of other things, and I'm going to go to the website here and talk about that in a second. But we have a degree here, and we have, in my opinion, one of the best degrees in the country, okay? And I have data to back that up. Who in here has heard of SMU Guildhall? Okay. SMU Guildhall is like, SMU is a college here in Dallas, and they have a gaming program called the Guildhall. And year after year, it's considered the best video game program in the country by like one of those like agencies that figures that out with all their data. So we are right down the street. We share some of the same professors. We have all the same software, all the same computers, and we teach the same stuff. So if they're the best in the country and we do pretty much the same stuff for like a lot less of the price, we're probably pretty good, right? Yeah.
I saw the website. How do they actually transfer to an advisor and say this is the degree I want to do and take care of the class stuff?
Yeah, you have to, if you want to be in the video game degree, you have to go to the STEM advisors in Wichita Hall and you have to declare your degree. And if you're interested in the game design degree, you want to do it as soon as possible so you don't waste any time taking classes and paying for classes that don't mean anything to you. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
We have a very specific degree, and it has very specific classes in there. So who else has taken other game design classes or other in the degree? Okay, what classes? Animation. Okay. We'll go over some of the classes here in a second. Okay, so anyway, I just wanted to get that out of the way. So we do have a game design degree here, and we have a community here, a game community, okay? Game design community. And we have multiple things, and there's like posters outside the door over here for our game club, which meets on Friday. And they like play games, and there's like we have an esports team. They're very like active, and they compete, and they're nuts. I can't even like get involved with those guys because they're just on another level. We have a programming club, so if you're interested in programming, how many programmers do we have in here? One, two, maybe some more. We're all gonna try a little bit of programming. Maybe, and then you can see, we use, on your desktop, you'll see there's something, Epic Games Launcher, that is the Unreal Engine, which is what we're primarily going to focus on. We do have Unity in here, and if you're taking the game program, you will do some Unity stuff, but I like to focus on Unreal because it's easy, and it's super freaking powerful, and it's one of the main ones in the industry. Unreal and Unity are the main ones in the industry. Who have heard of Unreal and Unity before? Okay, awesome. Yeah, they're really powerful. Most everything is made with either one of those. There's some other stuff like Game Maker and these sort of things, but it's like very, very small part of the pie. What else? So we have Game Club, Programming Club, and then we have events where I bring in speakers from the industry. That's going to happen soon, and I'll let you know when that's going to be. Okay. All right, everybody go to a internet browser. And I want you to, let's say Chrome, so we're all on the same page. I want you to go to richlandcollege.edu/game. Yeah, it should auto take you there. So I had a website, and it was my own website for this program, and they recently stole it from me. And basically like transferred all the information over to this website, so it's not as pretty as mine was. And I've, some information might be missing on here, but I'm gonna go over as much of it as I can. Who hasn't been to this website? Okay, so most of you guys have been to this website. That's great. So first and foremost, there's a video on here. At some point, if you haven't watched it, watch it. It's an 8-minute video. It talks about our program and a bunch of stuff. There is degrees and certificates. I guess we can click on that. richlandcollege.edu/game. richlandcollege.edu/game in an internet browser. We can do it. I believe in you. Everyone in this room can do it.
Yeah, when you launch in Chrome, it just doesn't load.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, so 8 minute video here, watch it, it's pretty cool. Go ahead and click on degrees and certificates up at the top. This degree is an incredible value. And I'll tell you why. Because does anybody know what a bachelor's degree costs at like a normal college?
Too much.
Ridiculous amount of money. All right. And I have students that graduate from my program every single term and go off and get a job or start their own company. Okay? For like $4,000 or whatever it is, which is not very much. Other than being in like student debt for like years. If you scroll down to the different specializations, these are gonna give you a good idea of what you can do. Some of the software that we use, I recently updated this like literally last term. Some of the positions, actually these are the positions we focus on in the creative aspect of the degree. Level design, character rigging, 3D, character art, 3D animation, game design, lighting artist, sound designer, concept artist, 3D artist, producer. There's a ton of stuff missing. There's more stuff missing from here, but in general, those are the kind of the things that we focus on. So when I say in here earlier that I need you guys to figure out what you want to do and as soon as possible, that's a good list to look at if you're interested in the creative side of the degree. There's also like, you know, actually, yeah, that's a good list to look at. There's probably more stuff, but this is, we're going to be focused on a lot of this stuff. Yes? Game designer, so you have level designer and you have game designer, and then there's like world designer, and then there's like all these different ways to describe it. But basically what level design does typically is level design, you build levels and you like block out levels so that you're in charge of like the flow of like a level and like where the doors are and traps and all this sort of stuff, right? You're responsible for like the player running around in it while it's just boxes and there's no colors and lights. 1 second. Game designer is the type of person that deals with documentation mostly. So they're like coming up with the ideas for the game, right? Game design is a position that is much needed because as you're going through the game development process, there is a million questions that are gonna come up and you gotta have a dedicated person or team or people that come up with those answers. Otherwise, it's designed by committee and it's chaos.
What exactly does a concept artist make? Areas, characters, creatures?
Good question. So I just Googled concept art game, and you're gonna see a lot of things that concept artists do. Okay, they can do environments, they can do characters, they can do weapons.
I'm good with characters.
That's good. That's good. I will say that anything character related is going to be extremely competitive in the industry. 3D character artist is like, it's very competitive in the industry because if you think about it, everybody grows up drawing characters or playing with dolls or playing with G.I. Joes or whatever, teddy bears and all this sort of stuff. And everybody, a lot of people want to be character artists, okay? Whether it's just drawing or whether it's 3D. And in a game team, let's say you have 50 people in the team, you only need like one character person. Because one character person can do like all the characters, right? Rather, like, let's say environment artists who build all the props and stuff, we need like five of those people. So there's more jobs available for...
I think I'd be the concept artist.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not here to like just like make you one way or another. I'm here to just give you information.
I'm just looking at what strengths I have.
Yeah, absolutely. And you want to focus on your strengths. I mean, if you have God-given talent, you want to use that. If you were born and you can draw characters like nobody's business, go for it. And I'll do everything I can. But I'm going to give you the data, and I'm going to tell you that, you know, sometimes it's better to, if you're trying to go into a highly competitive game job, it's better to get into something else like maybe a tester or whatever, and then work your way into that. So instead of trying to get in as a 3D character artist, it's very competitive, you get in as like an environment artist. Do you know what I'm saying? You're still drawing and you're still doing the things you love, but it's so competitive that you want to get your foot in the door the other way. Any other questions about the creative side of the industry?
You said something about the props and stuff, like what job is that?
So is this drawing or like modeling or what? So I'll go over multiple things.
What I've heard is there are people who will actually make like the physical like weapons and stuff.
Yeah.
In video games.
Right. All right, so I just Googled 3D environment artist.
It's usually environment art.
Yeah, it's environment art. So this would be like an environment art piece. Okay.
Dishonored 2?
I don't know what it is, but it's a model. It's a 3D model, okay? And you model these in 3D modeling programs. Now if I type in 3D prop artist, it's going to be the same sort of thing. That's a prop, or weapons are technically props. So 3D environment artist, 3D prop artist, all this is the same thing. So now if you just want to talk about, and then we already went over concept artist, which can do all this stuff as well. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Any other questions on the creative side of the degree? Yeah.
Do animators mostly focus on character animation, or do they animate like background objects and stuff?
Everything.
Or is that... I'm more asking about the line between animation and VFX.
Oh, animation and visual effects. That's a good question. I don't have visual effects artists on here, do I? I need to update that.
Because I saw a video of VFX, like something they called VFX, which I thought would be under the umbrella of animation.
Mm-hmm. Yes, they're separate. You have visual effects artists and you have animator. And the difference is visual effects artists do like explosions, fire, flames, smoke, electricity. Animators do like a character running and jumping and doing flips, or, you know, a car that animates out of the garage and drives down the street, or a ball that bounces, or a weapon that, you know, gets thrown across the room or whatever. Makes sense?
Yeah.
Yep.
So I want to go into the programming course, but I'm still interested in like design aspects of games, mainly because I want to start my own company and make kind of my own games. So I need to. Would it be possible? Like, is it possible for me to take electives in the?
Absolutely. Absolutely. This degree, it's very elective based. You do need to choose a specialization, though. All
right.
So what I would recommend, like, say you're a programmer, like, just like you, you're a programmer and you want to focus on, but you also want to, like, do some game design, okay? So that's fine. So you want to be a programmer, you want to take the programming side of the degree. You're going to start learning programming. You can take any of these classes that you want, right? Any of the other classes that you want. They are going to be additional to the programming degree, though, because the programming degree is like all programming. Because, I mean, you're learning, like, in the programming degree, you learn C++, you learn C sharp, and you learn, what's the other one? What's that?
Java.
No, we don't teach Java. We teach C++ because it's Unreal, we teach C sharp because it's Unity, and then teach another one, but I have brain block right now.
Well, Unity also uses JavaScript sometimes.
Yes, but C sharp is like the main one.
Yeah.
And then C sharp we can also apply to like many other things as well, so we teach you C sharp.
Oh, you're talking about Python, right? Python.
I'm not sure if Unity does Python, to be honest with you.
I think UE4 does.
I don't know. I know Python's a great language, though. We focus on the stuff that like you're actually going to be able to use when you get out into the real world. Most game development companies use C++ with Unreal and use C# with Unity. Not to say that you can't use Python, but we just don't do that. But yeah, so pick a specialization as soon as you can and go with that. Anyway, Yeah, and so on the programming side of the degree, it's just, it's all programming. Because if you become a programmer and you go work for somebody, generally you're going to be doing a lot of programming. If you start your own company and you're doing programming, you're probably going to still be doing a lot of programming. You know, and you can develop any of those other skills as well. Also, like, when we make a game in here as a group, like, I have, like, the game design team. And so we have a game designer, which is someone that their job is the doc. But when it comes to, like, decision-making and stuff, or just, like, brainstorming, you can be a part of that team as well, and then still come back in here and be a programmer. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So we, the way, you'll see how we get it set up, it's very cool like that. Any other questions about the programming side of the degree or the creative side of the degree? This is the time. Don't be shy. Okay.
So for, like, on the game design side, is that basically, like, the whole team is just planning out what the game is going to be like, in terms of, like, story, level design, and stuff like that?
You mean for this class?
Or, like, what a game designer does, the game designer side of the thing, of the game development?
Yeah, I mean, in general, their responsibility is to make the decisions on, like, you know, yeah, like, all that stuff.
Yeah, I might look into that thing, because I feel like I've been kind of, like, planning my own thing with the thing I mentioned having to do with the elements. I kind of want to, like, maybe look into the game designer part of it.
Great.
It just seems like up my alley.
Yeah, I mean, look at this list, whatever. You know, seems, and then we're also, everybody's going to try some programming too, so you may not know, and that's part of this class, is learning what you don't know. Some of the other guys over there, anybody? Yeah.
I had more of a question for the overall space of the course, or the degree class.
Okay.
I'm not going to be able to take multiple classes in one semester.
Okay.
And I'm going to break it down between summer semester and then winter semester. Is that going to be possible, or is it,
this course over the summer?
This one,
we do offer courses over the summer. It's very possible to do what you're saying.
Okay.
Did you have a question, my man?
If we haven't learned much before about using this stuff for the creative side, is that what we're going to be learning in class, is how to use everything?
Yes. We're going to try and go over as many of these aspects as possible. Yeah, I'm going to really try, and this is gonna really great for me because I don't have my senior classes that I'm teaching this year, so I'm really going to be able to, like, really work with you guys and focus heavy on what we're doing in here and give you kind of my all, if that makes sense. So I'm excited about doing that because normally I'm teaching, like, senior classes and other stuff, and it's a lot. Any other questions? Okay, let's move on. All right, click on learn more about your program on the main page. And we can go to the video game showcase. How many people have been to this website? Anybody been here? All right, here it's don't go here, but this is the old website that we pulled over all the stuff onto this new website, and you can see some of the games that we've made here. These are games that we've made that all the students have made here at the college, and I mean we've kicked ass here, just to be honest with you. But this is a list of some of those games. One of them is missing on here. Again, we just transitioned over this information. But you can read about these games that we've made here and watch videos and stuff. So we're for real. We actually make games. Yes?
Will we use, like, the motion capture stuff, or?
Good question. We do have a motion capture system here, and it is, like, four doors down, and we have our own room. We have a dedicated motion capture and virtual reality lab. So we have, like, Oculus and, what's the other one? Vive. Yeah, we have the Vive, and we're not going to do any mocap in this class, and I honestly think what's going to happen to that room is we're gonna transition that room to more of a, we're gonna head in the direction of more virtual reality and less motion capture. And it's gonna be, yeah, so we're gonna actually have like a dedicated like VR class for, we're gonna have a dedicated VR class. Yeah. Which, it's pretty cool. Yes.
Is there a way to, like, from that GIF you showed with the little yellow dude running,
mm-hmm.
or just more lively animations and stuff, is there, I guess we'll learn how to do that without a mocap thing?
Yeah, I'm going to show you how to do a bunch of animation stuff. I'm going to show, well, we're not, this is an animation class. This is game class. So in this class, we're going to teach you guys how to make a game as a team. That's what we're doing in here. And we're going to teach you all of the elements and aspects that go into game design. Animation is one of those things. We're not going to do a character animation tutorial in here. We are going to do an animation tutorial in here, but we're going to use a specific type of software. We're going to use like animation libraries and stuff. Does that make sense? So you will be working with animation. You will, as a animation, you will be able to do animation stuff in here. Okay, but you won't be doing like heavy character animation. Basically, the way we're going to look at it in here is like we're not going to be creating original content. What we're going to be doing is taking content from like online libraries or different marketplaces and stuff and putting a game together, like Legos. You know how you go buy a Lego set and like there are, you already have enough Legos to build the thing and you just put them together? That's what we're going to be doing in here. So we're gonna have, already going to have animations that already are animated, level prop set pieces that are already made, right? So like if you're going to be an animator on a team, you're going to be putting those into the engine, putting those into Unreal and understanding how all that works. And then the next classes in the degree, you're going to learn how to animate from an animation instructor, or how to model 3D objects from a 3D modeling instructor, or how to draw concept art from a concept art pro. Our concept art teacher here works for Netflix and has worked for Disney and is amazing and is current. Like, most of our professors here actually work in the industry, which is really cool. We're lucky to be in Dallas where there's over, you know, 30 video game companies in the area, and there's double that in Austin. Probably more now. It's insane. Anyway, so these are some of the games we made. Okay, so let's go back. Level design gallery. That's interesting. I guess this was added. Industry relations. We have, as I told you, we have at the bottom, we bring in professionals to do talks here and stuff. And if you click on some of these talks, these are some of the past talks that have happened at Richland College. And we just have those recorded if you're interested. They're pretty cool. And I just closed the website. Genius. Pure genius. Okay, technology. Some of you guys were asking what we can do, what we use here. You can look on the desktop and see all the programs that we use. We use an absolute ton of programs because there's like, you know, tons of, in all the creative aspects and programming aspects, it's like there's so much technology here. As you can see, Alienware, which is what you're working on right now, Unreal Engine, Unity, Oculus, Gear VR. We have, oh yeah, we have that as well. We have Vive. Here's just some other stuff that we use. Maya, Houdini, Substance, Trello, Discord. All this stuff we're going to go over. But you can look through all that. Student resources. This is pretty good. We keep track of all the video game companies in the area. So you can see a list of all the companies here in the area. These are all video game companies. We have students at a lot of these companies that have graduated from here. We also have students in, like, London and, like, all over the friggin' place. I still keep up with all those people. Let me see. I have some tips here for internships if you guys are interested in internships. I tend to, like, when students talk, we have an internship class in the degree where I give you credit for doing an internship. And students are always asking me how to get an internship in the video games industry. And I've just said it so many times, I just decided to write it on here. It's pretty, like, kind of duh stuff, but, like, if you read it, sometimes it helps to read it, if that makes sense. Tips from industry pros. So these are all some tips that I gathered from some industry pros and put them on here for certain types of positions. Some of the other ones we're filling in. You can read those. Portfolio tips and guidelines. These are really good too. If you want to be a programmer, just read some of this stuff. Want to be an animator, read some of this stuff. It never hurts. Let's see. Some of this stuff is buried in here and I just don't even know where it's at. Okay. So also there's a tab on the right called Student Experiences, and whenever we have a student that graduates from here and either starts their own company or goes and works for somebody, they absolutely butchered this. Like, it's horrible. Like, as you can see, we have it called Alumni Spotlight on my old website here, and it looks 10 times better. But, I mean, we have students at, like, Blizzard and, like, some other places, and we always do, like, an exit interview. And so you can go in and read, like, the exit interviews for our students that leave here, and they talk about, like, kind of how they found the program and what their experience was like in the program and stuff like that. As you can see, it's laid out a whole lot better on my other website, but whatever. They butchered it, man. Let's see, whatever. I don't know what any of this stuff is. Anyway, any questions on the website? Okay. Let's see. All right. So one of the goals in here is for us to. Let's say you decide you want to do the game design degree, okay? And you decide you want to be like an animator, okay? And you start working down the game design degree, and you work on some games, and you become, you know, you learn how to do animation or whatever. One of the last classes in the degree is what we call portfolio class, okay? And that is where you're going to take a lot of the work that you've done here in Richland, and you're going to make a portfolio so you can graduate and get a job. All aspects in here, everybody will make a portfolio. I'm going to show you an example of my portfolio. So I started in the industry as an animator, and I was on the artistic side, and so I did animation for a long time, and then I became a producer. And then I started my own company, and now I'm here. But I started, you always have to find somewhere to start, right? So this is my reel as an animator. And this is like from like 2007, so, or 2008, so don't, you know, judge me. example of like a portfolio, short, sweet, to the point, and just shows what you can do. And then they email you and call you and offer you a job, hopefully. So that was from 2008. So most of your professors in here, when you meet them, level design professor, all these guys, they're going to show you their work like that as well. Any questions on that? Okay. Another thing I want to show you guys is something I thought was really cool. It's like common practice now, but it wasn't when I did it. Everybody go to Steam. Google Steam Galactic Bowling. The words Steam and Galactic Bowling. Who in here doesn't know what Steam is? Who in here knows what Steam is? Awesome. Steam is a platform where they have games and stuff that you can buy and play. And Galactic Bowling was the first game that my company released. Our own intellectual property, our own design, our own everything, we put it on Steam. And I'll tell you my story here. It's pretty cool. So I went to college for animation, got into the video games design industry, worked on a couple games, became a producer, produced a couple games, quit, and worked on my own game at home on my savings with a virtual team of like 40 people from all around the world. And we built Galactic Bowling. And we, through my connections in the industry, Steam had just kind of sort of came out like 3, 4, 5, 6 years back when they released Half-Life 2. And I'd worked for a company at the time that had ties to Valve. And so I knew some people at Valve. And then just through my connections and networking, I got my game on Steam. And then the whole goal was to get a publishing deal for this game. So we launched it on Steam, and then we went to a bunch of different publishers, and then we were able to secure a publishing deal to do the Wii version. Everybody remember the Wii?
Yeah.
You throw the thing. So there's a Wii version of this game. Called Alien Monster Bowling League. And it is still for sale on Amazon. I think it is. Yeah, it is. Here we go. And we, for this version, we like added some more characters and we added some more gameplay modes. And obviously, it was different with the controller. So the publisher gave us an advance of $200,000 to start the to basically build the port to the Wii. And we did that, and that started my company, and we were off and running. Which is pretty cool.
So if people still buy it, you still get a... Ha.
Good question. The answer is no, I don't get any more money. And the reason for that is because I got screwed out of a contract with the publisher. Which leads me to the next thing that I'm going to tell you. Always read what you sign. If I can give you any other advice other than my neat little chart up there, start and end and death and all that, that's the best advice that I can give you. The second best advice that I can give you is always read what you sign. And if you don't understand it, find somebody that does understand it and can explain it to you. Because, man, I signed a contract, and I should be a multimillionaire right now because of this game. And I'm not because of some semantics. If you don't know what semantics is, Google that.
Yeah, I've always wondered, like, whenever I bought, like, a really, really old game, like, nowadays, I always wonder, hey, does this company still get my money if I like, buy this, like, out of, a game store or something? Like, do they still get it?
Every contract's different. A contract can be whatever you want it to be. Always read what you sign, do what you feel, go with your gut. That's my advice. Anyway, so that's my story. Any other questions on my story? All right.
A lot of publishers give you like a certain time limit, and after that, like, you stop getting paid, like 4 or 5 years or something.
Typically what they do is you do it in milestones. So like the first milestone would be like, all right, create level give us a full playable level with all the characters and one gameplay mode.
Yeah.
Then the next, and then that milestone is linked to like 40 grand.
Okay.
And then the next milestone is like, okay, do levels 3 through 6 now, give us the rest of the characters and do the credits. That milestone's linked to 50 grand. And then, yeah, makes sense. All right, went over GB. Okay, cool. So now comes the fun part of this class. How much time do we have? Anybody know?
40 minutes.
I
wanted to ask about, like, combined with the lab, like.
Yeah, so on your thing, it says something about, like, lecture and lab. Don't worry about that. We're just going to do our own thing in here. And to be honest with you, I mean, the lectures that I do in here, I'm not going to go up to the front of the room and stand and talk you guys to death for hours. We're all going to work together. I do workshop stuff. I don't do boring lectures. We all work together. Sometimes I have pre-recorded video. So I can't do everything, okay? Like, I can't be an animator and a programmer and a visual effects artist. And, like, there's too much for each of those things. So sometimes there's going to be a couple times I'm going to give you guys a video tutorial to watch of stuff that we've, you know, either made here or by some pro that we respect and trust or whatever. And I'm going to have you guys do that. But I'm going to give you a lot of hands-on stuff. But stuff like programming and stuff like that, I'm not a programmer, so I have to kind of turn you to some other stuff. But most of the time we're going to do like, most of the time, it's going to be like lecture lab mixed together, if that makes sense. All
right.
Any other questions? All right. Again, so now comes to the fun part. So we made a game in here. I would say probably the culmination of my career here. We made a game called Voodoo Escape. It's got a start to finish. It's got a boss fight. It's super cool. It's on your desktop. You can click that. If you've already opened it, and these computers have sound, you can, of course, plug your headphones in. There's Bluetooth headphones. And then you can also, on the start menu, you just go to sound, type in sound, and make sure that the right thing is set to default. And you can turn the volume up. You may have to mess with the sound settings on the monitor. It's really good to have the sound on while you play this game. So if you can figure that out, that'd be really good. So if you have Bluetooth headphones, you can. These computers have Bluetooth. But if you didn't bring your headphones, then don't sweat it. Just, you know. But yeah, so there's an icon on your desktop called Voodoo Escape.
Which sound setting?
So for sound settings, you just go to start, and you type in sound. Click on sound, and it'll take you to this. And you choose the monitor. I think it says like Dell something or other on yours. And set that to default. And guys, help the person sitting next to you. The people sitting next to you are going to be like your best friends. You know what I mean? But anyway, the rest of today, the goal is for you guys to get to the boss fight. That's the goal. And I'm going to give you some advice with this game. There's a bug in this game. And the bug is really bad. If you hit that bug, you will die and you can't continue forever. And the best advice that I can... Whoa.
What was that?
Best advice that I can give you is don't get hit by the enemies.
What is that? I don't think this works.
I think you need to, like, start the game over or something and test out your sound before you launch the game.
No, it's the computer.
What is that?
It works, I promise you. What's that?
It's the computer.
We're not going to focus on sound stuff anymore. Is that what you want to do, sounds? We do have a sound. We have a class that does that. And it's on the degree. It's an elective, but we just have one class. We don't really focus on sound here. There are other places. Like, if you're really interested in sound, there are places that are like sound program. You know what I mean? That's kind of what you want to. So we need sound. Like the game that we're making, we're going to need sound effects. We're going to need, and there's always usually one person in here that's either interested in sound. I can show you how to do all that. And if you want to be the sound person, you can be the sound person. We're going to need it anyway. Yes. Yeah. If you need to use, guys, this is college. If you need to use the restroom, go use the restroom. Don't have to ask permission or get a hall pass or anything like that.
I can't hear anything.
Anybody get their sound working?
I got mine working.
Can you help?
I got my sound.
You seem pretty smart. Think you can try and help her? Cool. Remember, don't get hit by the enemies, otherwise. There's a bug, and if you get hit by the enemies, you will fall into an endless black abyss. Not all the enemies, just one part of the game that you can die.
Okay, so
you need to figure that out. There's controls and instructions and stuff. Read those. That will help you. I actually have no idea, man.
Gotta make a good one for you to remember it.
Yes.